all the Hindu sampradayas are ultimately enlightenment, moksha based. They claim exclusivity only for you not to get diverted, distracted, wasting your time, energy. Never the exclusivity claim is on the goal. All our kandana mandana, the Shaivites saying Shaivism is the ultimate, Shakta saying Shaktism is the ultimate, and Vaishnavites saying Vaishnavism is the ultimate. All this kandana mandana was more not to let you get diverted and waste time, but not the exclusivity on the goal itself. That is why I insist all Hindus follow your sampradayas intensely. All my gurus, such juicy people. I have seen Panduranganar. See, Panduranganar lived in a place called Kirnathur in Thiruvannamalai. It is little away from main temple. Now the Thiruvannamalai has grown up to Kirnathur and even beyond Kirnathur. In those days, the Kirnathur used to be like a village outside Thiruvannamalai. Because after the Thiruvannamalai, there will be a lot of agriculture field, farming, and then only you will reach Kirnathur in those days. Every day he will come by walk or in some two-wheeler. Some of his disciples, his students will pick him up and bring him to temple. I have seen whenever Thondai Mandala Adhinam, Guru Maha Sannidhanam comes to Thiruvannamalai and camps in Thiruvannamalai, he will never, 230th Guru Maha Sannidhanam was ruling that time. So, he will never miss bringing flowers and bilva for his puja. Same way, whenever Tiruchiswami is from the Shakta Sampradaya, Vedanta Shakta Sampradaya, whenever he comes and stays, he will usually stay in Isanyamatam, in Thiruvannamalai. Later on, he had built his own branch, Pavalakkundru Matam. Till then, he used to stay in Isanyamatam or Oyamatam, in the house, the mutt opposite to the house in which I was born and brought up. I have seen whether for Thondai Mandala Adhina Sannidhanam or for Tiruchiswami, the absolute sincerity with which Panduranganar will bring flowers and bilva leaf. Same way Kuppammal. How sincerely she will try to collect some flowers, fruits and go and have darshan of Kundrakudi Adigalar, whoever are Kribananda Variyar. An amazing friendliness and understanding existed among all of them, created a very conducive ambience for me to imbibe, internalize all these traditions